Hello, my fellow ghouls and ghosts. How are you tonight, or today, or wherever you're watching this from? Welcome to another episode of Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines. This is the Final Nights Pod 1.6 version alpha, And if you're watching this right now, it is July 10th, and the full mod has been officially released. So please, it's been out for less than 24 hours now. So if you haven't, go check it out, go download it, and have fun with it. So we are still continuing our alpha play, though, because I don't want to give up in the middle. Because I don't want to stop in the middle of my gameplay. So I don't think that much stuff has changed regarding the Samedi when it comes to this kind of thing, other than maybe the stuff that Zeromorph did to Dr. Malcolm, and some other graphical things. And so we're just going to continue on with this alpha version. I already lost blood from blabbing away here and not doing anything. Let's go and I'm not going to spend a lot of time bothering or boring you guys with me gathering blood as I head back into the sewers here. I will bore you with looking at logs and wondering, where did we leave off? So let's go ahead and do that. What did we leave off? Alright, you've dealt with a reporter for Pisha. We need to go visit Pisha again. You're looking for the cause of the epidemic for the Anarchs. Fat Larry, businessman extraordinary, wants you to acquire a briefcase. We still need to go to the Empire Arms Hotel to take care of Jezebel Locke. I had to talk to him. We need to go into the parking garage to take care of this. And we need to go to... Let's go back to Santa Monica. That sounds like a good idea. Let's go back to Santa Monica. We're going to take care of Tongue's quest, and we're going to take care of the Elizabeth Dane quest. Then we'll head back to downtown. Alright, back in good old Santa Monica. Let's go ahead and grab one of these rats here just to have a little bite to eat. There you are, buddy. Here, come here. Come here. I got one point in brawl now. I can at least try to get a rat. Let's get our map going here, because I know that's the way to the Ocean House, and I think that's the way to Jeanette, or the Asylum, great. B is not what I'm looking for. I think I'm looking for, like, D. I'm looking for D. Let's head back this way. So, yeah. Get a map on the wall here. Go and orient ourselves. We need to go for D, yeah. So behind us, this way. We'll go ahead and take care of the Elizabeth Day, and then we'll go talk to Tongue and take care of him. Alright, what are you doing here?
I just wanted to make...
Okay, might need some equipment. What does he have? He doesn't have much right now. I forgot why I do have a crossbow on me. That's very nice. I'm not going to buy any rounds just yet for my gun. I don't really need them, so we'll hold off on that. He will have better weapons for us in the future as well. Alright, up to the Elizabeth Dane. Let's get our office gate ready to go. There we go. Thank you. So, Samedi, don't talk to that guy. He will run screaming from you. It will alert everybody, and it will just end in total disaster. So we're going to use our stealthy obfuscate skills to get through the good old Elizabeth Dane, like I usually do, anyways. And I think our hacking's high enough where we can actually use the computer. That is to say, unless someone is in the room. Sometimes there is. Lockpick this. Easy enough. So here's the records room. We can unlock that if we wanted to. Let's go upstairs first and check that computer out. And there is someone there. That is unfortunate. That is very unfortunate. I'm just looking around to see if there's something I can throw. There is something I can throw. Maybe I can distract him? Let's do a quick save real quick. Nope, he's really into that computer. So we're not going to be able to hack into the computer. I don't have any disciplines that I can mesmerize that guy with, so we're going to have to do this the hard way. I don't want to do it the hard way. I want to do the easy way. And of course, this is a lockpick difficulty of 6 to get in this records room. And if we check our security and burglary, is only at 4. And so even with a blood buff only pumps it up by 1 in the final nights. And that would only push it up by 5, so we are going to do this the hard way. Which means opening that door. Let the doors open all the way. And we're going to have to come outside. Is this door not open? I guess you can't open that door. Okay, well, let's open this one. We'll have to go on this side. Can't go that way. And we'll just have to go out this way. Very unfortunate. But it will do. It will do, Mr. Pig. I wonder if I can go and get into the records room, like, right now. Well, that was easy enough. This lock was easier to figure out than the other one, so we're going to pick up that ship manifest there. We're going to have to pick up a police report, and we're going to have to, find the Elizabeth, or look at the Unkarn sarcophagus. So let's head up here real quick. Just glad the timer for Obfuscate is working. Third person view. Should be a table around the corner. Not this corner. Should be around here somewhere. And just for safety's purposes, let's keep that on a fast save, a little quick save there. Just in case I make an error, which I am not prone to do. I am absolutely perfect at this game. It's pro plays you're watching. It should be the police report. Police report has been obtained. Now we just need to go look at the Elizabeth Dane. So far we've got a total of 2 XP points from this quest, just from picking up 2 pieces of paper. Obfuscate is about to run out, so we're about to kick it back online here. Here we go. Now, if that guy wasn't at the computer, or we could find some way to mesmerize him or take him back, then we could have easily just used the ship deck cameras to view everything and not even have come this far. Alright, so a total of 3 XP. We should be good for this quest. Let's check it out. You've successfully completed your task. Okay, we report back to Prince. Well, let's get the hell out of Dodge. This guy is... Now, let's see if we can go back the way we came. Where are you going? Okay. Secret. We gotta be quiet. We gotta be quiet. In real time, as well as in game time. If I speak too loud into the game, then they will discover me. See, now there's more cops here than when I first arrived. But maybe, just maybe, I can sneak around them and get
some
in here.
Some kind of symbol. Are you guys in touch with Deepwater, MVMC, or who? What do we have here?
Not immediately familiar.
Well, look, Gannett, this is something we need to get squared away before anyone puts any stakes down. I mean, look, this will save all of us some work later if we get this shit squared away now.
All right.
Agreed? We go through this every goddamn time.
Bill, what do you make of
this? Perfect. There we go. No similarity to any local gang signs I know. Didn't know if it was hard to know if perhaps it was associated with the It's a bunny, what? Symbol. We'll go out this way. We did use a lot of blood points just to obfuscate through the entire thing. Just kind of zip around this guy. Zip being a relative term here. I'm going to save it one more time, and then hoping I won't need obfuscate. I can just kind of like sneak the rest of my way out here. Just hug the wall here. Obfuscate is now out. And it looks like we're getting away with it. Great. There we go. So we grabbed a total of 5 XP just from doing the Elizabeth Dane quest. We're now up to 20. We're banking 28 experience points. And we're still not spending anything. We are keeping them banked for when we absolutely need them. But we don't absolutely need anything right now. We will make that decision once we come upon any suspect situations. All right, now I do have to head back in the sewers, and I'm going to go feed on some rats, but I will meet you guys at my Santa Monica apartment first, just to check to see if that $50 is there. All right, everyone, we are back at my apartment, and now, or the old Santa Monica apartment, and we're going to do the moment of truth. Nope. No money. Well, that's a shame. That is a damn shame. Let me go back up to the actual apartment. And not forget that I have a bunch of stuff lying around here that I need to sell. I should actually... Is this a bottle of pills? That is a bottle of pills. I never noticed that before. It's probably just because I popped my inspection up by one. What about that watch? No, the watch isn't back there. But at least I found those pills. Those barely take up any rooms in my inventory. So I'm wondering if I should just go ahead and drop some stuff here. Let's drop that. And we'll drop this. There we go. We'll come back and sell all that stuff later. Once our finance score is up a little bit more. Well, that's a disappointment, but now we're going to go back to... We don't need to go back to Tongue, per se. We just need to head to Foxy Boxes. If we go to Santa Monica here... Is it downtown? Nope. Acid Destroyer. Yeah, the Cathayan's computer. So let's go that. Let's go there. So this Tongue quest is a new quest for TFN. It actually has been in the older versions, but just in case you didn't know, this is one of them. All right, reports. And send data. Now destroy data. Look, hacking is so easy. An old item from old acquaintance of mine that has just returned from Europe. He's a trader in books and lore, so meeting him is probably in your best interest. Okay, so he's just talking about Akeem, which I've already met. I've kind of gotten a jump on that one. Okay, guys, I did come back to my apartment here in downtown, in the sewers downtown, and in my mailbox, there was a envelope containing $50, so that's good to know. I guess I just had to leave the area and come back, just to kind of, like, make sure it was reset or something like that. So let's see where we are real quick and see where the last round is. Last round is number 9. It's right behind us. We can interrupt through I or H. Let's just interrupt through I, so we're just kind of straight back. Okay, and here we are back in the last round. If you notice, the music in the back is going to be different from what you're hearing. You're not going to hear people talk. I did get kicked for a copyright notification in my last video, and that music was down really low. But, so you're not going to hear any voices. Here, I'll just say it myself. 2 minutes, newbie. All the time I've got to spare right now.
Tell me about yourself.
All right, you came to California. Is it worth it? Do you have to keep constantly fighting? Why keep fighting? Why don't you just join the... you must have learned a lot in that time. Any advice? All right. There we go. And we got our free stat into melee. Should we ever need to use it? Let's talk to Damsel real quick. Some questions. Okay, I don't have anything. Okay, there you go. So we've got everything we needed from Nines. I think the next step is to go ahead and take out the Tong and the thugs in the parking garage and complete that quest for Larry. And then we go and talk to Larry, get all that stuff for Venus, and then we will head to Pisha and get that quest finished for her. So let's go ahead and sneak back into the old sewers here and head back over to where Larry is. Larry's kind of like near where we first entered downtown. Alright guys, I was thinking about making an executive decision here. I think I'm going to go ahead and pop that fourth point into obfuscate so I'm not doing this the entire game and having to consistently go into the sewers. So I think since we're rocking at 18 or at 29, it's going to cost 18 to get off skip before, and it's going to leave us with 11 XP points. That's fine. I think we can work with that. I don't see us having any real battles in right now, at least. But if we do, it's fine. We'll be good. Obfuscate 4 is going to be a lot easier to use, but we need to activate it first. So let's go ahead and kneel down, activate, And then, there we are. Good to go. Executive decision. Now I can just run straight through. And investigation is picking up a silver ring here. There we go. Nice to find a little something lying on the ground there due to inspection being up just a little bit. Run by this guy. So I like to think this is going to be a relatively short run, guys. I am going to just obfuscate it the entire way. I'm not going to take any of the vents. Yeah, let's just do it. Maybe I'll do this in a quick speed time. All right, here we go. And there's our briefcase. Just waiting for us to scoop it up in our lovely, lovely, gnarly arms. Let's go and save it. All right, guys, I am back. I just had to do I stepped away from the computer for about 3 hours, but I'm back. You didn't even notice, did you? You didn't notice I was gone. Hey, but I just know that I don't think I can grab this briefcase unless I actually do go through like this last vent. So let's go up here real quick. And let's see. I think I can get through here and then hopefully not get busted. I'm not sure I might be able to. Why can't I get up here? Oh, because I wasn't kneeling down. Derp. Okay, let's try this. I don't know why I didn't just stand up. But... okay, yeah, because I think it glitches out if you grab that case. And don't go through some of the vents here. So we're going to just go and try to grab this. I've been over, pick it up, drop low, and you open fire. There it goes. Okay, so just a heads up, if anyone's wondering, that you do have to actually go through at least the last two vents for this to activate, otherwise it'll glitch out on you. Okay, 14 XP points, that's nice. We'll let these guys kill themselves. And I'm glad I did leave the... some of the stuff back in my apartment so I can just pick up this and take it back with me. Guys, stop missing. Stop missing. I'm gonna go ahead and eat one of these guys like you. And go get that obfuscate back up. There we go. Kinda wish I left the weapons up there. But I'm not going to come back. I may come back down here, actually. I may do that off screen. Just come back down here and grab a lot of this stuff. So I'll grab this guy. Bring him up. Nice and tasty morsel. We will pick up this. This weapon. We'll pick this up. There'll probably be some other melee weapons lying around here. And like I said, I may come back here and pick all these things up one by one as I... and sell them off. Oh, that hitbox is so lame. Alright, well, that's just one less we have to do. Let's go and kill this guy. Get obfuscate. Oh, I did not want obfuscate or blood heal. I wanted obfuscate. Oh, well. No worries. Leave that lion on the ground. Should be good to go. There's another bat. There's a knife there. Let's go pick that up. Yeah, a lot of weapons lying around here at the bottom. So we'll come back here and we'll come by and we will actually bring these back up to Larry and sell them one by one. It will be tedious. It will be long. You won't have to see it. I'll even grab the weapons from the pawn shop and then
I'll show you how much money I'll have. Because right now we're sitting at, as I said, we got $254. We got $200 from that one for Akeem. And we have $50 from breaking into that bank account and stealing $50 out of that. So, and of course, we had $4 left over from buying all those books. So hopefully we'll get this finance point from Larry to boost our finance up by one, which will put our total barter at 5. And then I think we'll be good at 5. I'm not sure if I need to continue on and pump it up even more. Should be good at 5. We'll get nice bang for a buck from selling stuff. But instead of showing the rest of those guys, I will meet you back at Fat Larry. All right, we are back with Fat Larry here. I am going to go and come out of Obfuscate. I don't think anyone will be able to see us over here, and I'm going to go and give it a nice little quick save. And let's talk to Larry.
Oh.
Okay, I got the briefcase.
Outstanding. Yeah, that's beautiful. Everything looks in order.
How much money is he going to give us?
Yo, you hit it.
There we go. There's my finance
cool
increase.
With me.
How much money we get? $100. That's not too bad. Another experience point. All right. And the quest complete. So I'll give him a thanks.
Say, my girl down at confession.
All right. Yeah, I'll check it out. First, I need to buy some merchandise.
Yeah, what you do with all this stuff?
Okay, I will, Larry. All right. So. Now that we have a discount and we have a barter skill, actually, let's look at our barter. Barter is now 5 because we have that plus point put into finance, and we'll see that manipulation also handles that. It also handles coercion. I forgot about that. I'm going to go ahead and talk to Larry.
My man.
And do some shopping. So we can get a set of heavy clothing for $390. Can't afford it right now, but we can start selling stuff off. I don't want to sell off this pyro crossbow. I think it might actually come in handy. And this SNW special has been coming really handy as well. I want to keep all these weapons, honestly. So let's keep all these weapons. And we will sell the... Let's go and sell the weapons that we have, the melee weapons. We'll sell that for 8, and the knife for 10. And go back. Now we can start selling this stuff off. So regular pill bottles, $7. Yeah, we have the ship manifest. We still need to talk to LaCroix. Prescription bottle. Sell. Sell that drug box. Got a lot of stuff here. Sell that. We can even sell the cash box that we got from Gallery Door. A couple silver rings. That's really nice. Okay, cool. We do need to deposit some things into our trunk at our apartment, because I don't want to get too much stuff in our inventory, otherwise it'll start glitching out the game. But right now, I do want to go ahead and buy this next set of heavy clothing. How about that? Okay, so now we got our next set of armor. That's going to pump us up to... Yeah, it's going to help out with our armor rating 1. It's going to be great. No stat penalties from using it. We're just wearing a shirt now, pretty much. We look, there's all our stuff here. We're now better at not getting bashed as much. We can still use with another point of stamina, but we'll hold off on that for right now. I guess the next stop is to go ahead and make a trip to LaCroix. And tell him about the Elizabeth Dane. Actually, we can make a stop by our apartment since we're down right next to the place. So here we go. Let's check our email real quick. No emails. It's no emails. No emails can be good emails, right? And we don't really have a trunk, do we? We don't have a storage space. That. I mean, we could store stuff in our, I guess, our fridge. So we'll go ahead and do that. Fridge is our storage space. This is the diary from the Ocean House. We don't need that. We don't need the driver's license. We don't need Milligan anymore. Appointment book for that poor girl. We do need these two things to get to LaCroix. And really, I'm going to go and put these weapons in here as well. Because I'm going to go back and pick that stuff up in the garage and come back and sell it. So we'll leave that there. There we go. Nice and tidy. Let's go visit LaCroix.
Hey!
Oh!
I know this might seem creepy and all, but please, don't blow me off, okay? Someone told me I could find you here. I mean, I've been looking all over for you since that night. Because I just wanted to...
Okay, great. I forgot that Zeromorph did put Heather down here under Venture Tower because it just seemed weird putting her right in front of Venture Tower, and then because we're not going into see LaCroix through the front door, so him placing her down here in the basement of the tower is a great decision. I actually forgot about her, to be honest, so I'm glad. Let's see, how did you know I'd be in this basement? Never mind, you look much better.
Only because of you. Here, I got you this.
I think she gives me, yeah, she gives me a silver ring. That's nice. Of course, Heather, I would love for you to stay
really?
With me.
I promise you won't regret.
Yeah, give me my money. Wait for me at my place. I can't have you following me around. It's dangerous.
I know.
Yeah. My dear Heather, what did I ever do without you? How about, my dear Heather, what did I ever do without you? I'll see you later. There we go. That's somewhat of a Samedi voice. All right, let's say before we talk to good old LaCroix.
I don't have...
All right, everyone with
and
an
the Ankarans are opened.
Yeah, who are they?
Those with each mind.
Okay. Certainly, is that all?
Yes, for the moment. You know...
Thank you, Nels.
Yes.
About Grout.
About Grout.
I'll go right away.
When we hear from Grout...
Goodbye. I wonder if I get any more money from him.
The Primogen...
I have a few questions. Never mind.
When we hear from Grout...
Okay. All right, guys, that's where I'm going to end the episode officially here, but I am going to tack on how much money I make from selling all these weapons and stuff. So I am currently sitting at $157. When I come back, I'll have sold this ring and all the weapons I find in the parking garage and also the stuff in my Santa Monica apartment, and then we will come back and I'll show you. All right.
Here.
Okay, so I just grabbed 20 bucks from Heather. She didn't give me that much. I was kind of hoping my... barter would garner me a little bit more money from her, but I don't need that, so that'll do for more. That'll do for now. So we got 20 extra bucks just from that, and now I'll go sell. Okay, so we got 177. Alright, let's do this. Okay, guys, before I finish up here, I did forget about visiting Pisha, so let's go and visit Pisha and get this quest started. Turn in, let her know that Milligan was down here, or she already knows Milligan was down here because she ate the poor bastard.
The kind fate was sealed.
All right, about those
yes,
artifacts.
For these items, a fetish is it is used.
All right. All right, get back to skin eating. It's all yours. All right, so we just finished that up. We got 18 points. We'll probably end this episode with banking another 20 points, which would be fantastic. I'm not gonna lie. Good thing is, with Obfuscate 4, we don't have to kneel down to get that, so... Okay, we're heading to the parking garage, so I'll see you again. Okay, guys, so it looks like the parking garage is completely out. I forgot that Zeromorph closed this up, and... Yeah, so once you complete it, you cannot go back in there. So, unfortunately, we're not going to be able to go back there and get money, or get the items that we wanted, so... That is completely out, but we can still head back to Santa Monica, which is what we're going to do. We can still go back to Santa Monica and grab our stuff. Okay, guys, we're back. We're about to do the last of our trying to sell things off here. Now, I have the severed arm on me, and now in the unofficial pass, you can sell the severed arm or any body parts to Pisha, and she'll give you a little money for it. So let's see if it's still true in the Final Nights.
Yes.
You seem a bit preoccupied with death.
Death is the ultimate.
Okay.
Yes.
A fetish okay, is. Okay, we know about that.
Yes.
But the items we want, a vampire that eats flesh is still disgusting.
If it satisfies you, I make an effort.
Another question. Yes. Okay, okay, so I cannot sell Pisha the severed arm. That is only in the unofficial patches that you can do that. And if you didn't know you could do that, you can do that. You can come down to your cell, and I think she gives you about $10 for each little piece of human meat that you find lying around. With that said, let's go ahead and bring up the severed arm and slap her with it. No, I'm not going to slap her with it. I am going to drop it. There it is. And the severed arm can remain here for the entire time. In fact, I want you to have it right here. Let's see if I can put it here. Nope, just kind of flies in there. Okay, well, Pisha, I didn't mean to disrespect your area, but there's a severed arm for you. It's free food. And with that, guys, let me show you how much we got. So we only have $277. We only managed to raise $100, I think, by selling what was left in the Santa Monica apartment, which is amounted to just to tire irons and baseball bats, and there's like one S&W special in there. So there wasn't that much. We got $100 more. We're at $277, which is better than the $4 we were at a little while ago. So I'm not going to complain too much about that. I guess I could go and check the diner or back up the beach house, which I didn't kill everyone at the beach house, but be that as it may, we're going to go ahead and end this episode here. Thank you so much for joining me, and I hope everyone has a wonderful, wonderful weekend. Smash that like, hit that subscribe, give a comment below, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.